people one side of the virtues, but I think life trips you up when you don't understand the opposite of your virtues. Mm-hmm. So if you understand love but do not understand hate, even though I don't want you to foster hate, but if you don't know what it looks like, what it feels like, what it sounds like, it'll jump on you and pounce on you. And you find the greatest successful people in the world are those whom you might say infuriate other people, but they're not really infuriating other people, they're stopping others from infuriating them, because they have momentum, they have direction, they know where they're going, and other wishy-washy people around them keep telling them why they should slow down and destroy their momentum. And I'm a consultant to business, but I tell my clients, I don't care about your business, I care about your people. And the only reason I consult to business is so that we can do something to improve life, because business basically controls most of the world. I mean, if you talk about IBM, its capital flow is bigger than some countries put together. And it employs more people than some countries have as a population. So corporate life seems to dominate us. And I have seen people go home crying. And I'm now writing about taking control of your career. But unfortunately, people don't know how to do that because they go to school to get a university degree and they think, oh, that might work.
Yeah.
Or they get a divorce, they think that'll make me happy. Or they get married and they think that'll make me happy. And they always think happiness is somewhere else. They go on holidays over there because over there I'll find happiness.
Because you touch on, like, university. You mentioned in some of your notes it's a kindergarten for adults.
Yes. If by 13 you don't have a gut feel and by 16 you're not sure, then I can assure you by 21 you still don't know. So you have people at 26 years of age still studying and still don't know where they're heading. No, I left school at 14 because I knew, and people called me a school dropout. And I said, what do you mean a dropout? What, is that you putting a negative tone on that? Because I finally knew where I was heading and what I was doing. Life is about advantage. And they think I have an advantage if I have a master's, whatever. But you're one of 50,000 people a year who get one. So now what's your advantage? And the real advantage for me is not, it's what's in your head. It's what you do with what you know. We are lopsided in our approach in that we all understand fear. None of us understand courage. And so when you fuse fear plus courage, you arrive at conviction. And when you meet someone with conviction, you call them control freaks. You call them hard to get along with. You call them prima donnas. But they know what they want to do. So as a digital age philosopher, my job is to help you ask the right questions. I found in life that if you tell people what to do, don't smoke, don't drink, don't do drugs, don't, they say, look, I've heard it all before, I know it, thank you, and they still go and do it because it is not their knowledge. So if they read a book and the book says do and don't, they say, look, yeah, I've heard that before. So what I do is I don't challenge them that way. I ask them to ask themselves the right questions, and I tell it in such a way that they build curiosity, and I leave them with that curiosity, and nothing torments someone them wanting to know the answer,
That's right.
Now, How to Lose Friends and Infuriate People must be very popular. It's in its third edition now.
Well, it hit number one in New Zealand.
Why do we avoid conflict?
Okay, well, because we don't have courage. And the definition of courage is to not allow anything or anyone to weaken your resolve. Many of us resolve, and we even have New Year's resolutions, and we say, I resolve that I will do this, I will stop smoking, I will tell my boss that I want a pay rise. But courage is not allowing people to weaken that resolve, which means the absence of courage. For example, if you lack courage, it means that you go want a pay rise, and your boss starts to threaten you, well, what are you going to do about it? Nothing, because you're 1 week away from poverty. Most people are one paycheck away from poverty. So that weakens your resolve. Where will I get another job? I don't have a good qualification. Oh, that'll weaken my resolve. So all of a sudden, what you know is to be true, you cannot articulate, you cannot enact, because other things get in the way.
That's exactly right. And you touch on the 9 modern diseases of failure.
9 deadly.
Deadly diseases.
Intangible that they are.
Yeah.
And these diseases cannot be seen. And so, for example, if I grab this, I'm sure it'll annoy everyone on television, and they'll say, what's this guy doing with this? See, it's tangible. And they say, gee, he's weird, because the tangible things are instant, and everyone can see it. Now, but can they look at someone, an executive or a child, and say that child has got this trait or that trait?
No.
And the 9 deadly intangible diseases begin with A, for abdication. And we abdicate. The very fact of buying insurance means I abdicate. I buy my car and I pay you $500 a year. And if anything happens to it, it's your problem. So I've abdicated my responsibility for my car. Now, we do that with school. We say I abdicate my education to the teacher.
15 years, yeah.
Yeah, and my welfare to the government, my future to the clairvoyant, my you know, wealth to the lottery, and my career to my boss, and my happiness to my lover, and everything's over there, remember I keep saying. And that is a disease. There are other diseases like selfishness, like simplicity. And these intangibles are not seen. Because how can you see a bastard, an idiot, a backstabber, a corporate monger?
Absolutely.
And when I did used to see them, is that good English? Yeah. When I did see them, my boss would say, Jonah, that's a personality clash. And I'd say, no, this guy's destroying our company. This guy is destroying people's energies at the office. But the boss can't see that because these idiots who actually destroy our lives know how to suck up to the boss. And they look really good up there.